voice that ends the silence meets me in my need. Like fireworks igniting in my chest, the weight of your glory, the reverence. Amid all that you would come to me, speak to me, I'm listening. Speak to me.
Thank you.
Speak to me.
For viewing us.
I'm listening.
In our channel. In YouTube. Coming to you with another kingdom, power, authority, park session provided by Global Diplomat College Center, Greenville, South Carolina. Joseph Forbes, God's holy prophet, ambassador, by the will of God. I want to focus on what I believe will be the key of kingdom of God living on earth. The Bible is called the law of God. Global Diplomat College Center mission is transforming students into leaders, leaders and agents of change. Now we go to the message. You cannot experience what you do not understand. Am I clear? You cannot experience what you do not understand. Our session topic is power of kingdom prayer, part one. Power of kingdom prayer, part one. Prayer is universal. The president pray, the Queen of England pray, prime ministers, judges, lawyers, doctors, politicians pray, churches, civil organizations, unions pray, families pray. Prayer is universal. But how do you pray? And who do you pray to? Am I making myself clear? We will rediscover the life of the King, the Lord Jesus Christ. We must take on his lifestyle, his culture, his glory. For the kingdom of God is not a religion. But the kingdom of God is the influence of heaven on earth. God's original plan is to establish, to extend, his heavenly kingdom on earth in the hearts of his sons and his daughter. Am I making myself clear? Seven principles of prayer. One principle is discipleship. Two, the keys of heaven. Three, intimate relationship with God. Four, law of prayer. Five, important priority. Six, understanding your God-given purpose. Seven, it's in pursuit of God. Am I clear? Now we go to the first principle. The church for 1800 years been busy but not effective. They've been doing good things but not the right thing. I grew up in religion. I participate in religious service. I was a Christian. I am not a Christian. I am a kingdom citizen. Growing up in religion, they teach you Sunday school. They had camp meeting revivals, healing revivals, and many other revivals. But they had no teaching on prayer. Prayer is the most important in our lives. Prayer is kingdom prayer. No denomination, no organization can claim prayer. Am I making myself clear? Now we'll rediscover about the King. King of Kings, Lord of Lords. The disciple, his students, came to Jesus. He was praying, and they were watching him pray. They came to him, and they said, Lord, that's King, teach us to pray. Discipleship. School of discipleship. The world is global diplomat college center classroom. We teach every nation on earth. It's our classroom. Luke 11:1. One day, Jesus was praying. Prayer is not just a prayer meeting or you're gathering certain believers together and say, let's go pray. That is not prayer. Prayer is, must be thought. One day, Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he was finished, notice, they watched him pray. They never met up to him while he was praying. When he was finished, one of his disciples, a disciple is a student, said to him, Lord, King, every king is Lord, and every Lord is King. Teach us teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciple. The prophet John taught his disciple how to pray. The church ecclesia must be taught to pray. What you pray for, how you pray, how you enter into prayer, how do you enter in the king's court, how do you address the king in prayer? They say, Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciple. Am I making myself clear? Those now in the school of discipleship prayer, as you join in with us at Global Diplomat College Center, Queen will extend to you how you should pray, what you should pray for. Now we understand now what we should pray for and how we should pray. He said, Jesus, to them, when you pray, whenever you pray, say, Father, there is only one Father, the Pope, the priests, the Roman Catholicism, they are not Father. Jesus said, call no man your Father, for there is one Father. So you address the king as a Father. The word Father means source, sustainer, provider, protector, multiplier. Papa, Abba, 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 Father. Hallowed be your name. Holy be your name. So your name is Holy Father. Am I clear? So when you go before him in prayer, you say, Holy Father. Hallowed be your name, your, not what you want, not what's on your mind, what's on the mind of the king. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth, in earth, as it is in heaven. Heaven is extending to earth. God's original plan is to establish, to extend his heavenly kingdom in our hearts on earth. Your will be done just like it is in heaven. Give us each day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, give us each day our daily bread. So you look to the Father, the sustainer, the provider, for the economy, for your resources, not to your president, Donald Trump, not to the presidents and your prime ministers. They are not your Father. They won't be elected by the people, but you look to our Father, our source, our provider, our protector. Give us this day Now, in a kingdom, you don't purchase. In a kingdom, you have benefits. Citizens have rights. So you go claim your benefit. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins. You don't go there praying for boat, car, house, children. You don't go there praying for what you want. But you ask forgiveness. Forgive us our sins. For we also forgive everyone who sinned against us. Our relatives, your husbands, your children, in your workplace, those who did you wrong. Now it's time to reconcile. Husband is not speaking to wife right now, prophetically, I see that. Children is angry with the parents. I see that. Mother-in-law is at war with them. Daughter, husband. Husband is angry with wife. You need to go and reconcile and forgive the one who sinned and do odds against you. And lead us not into temptation. Temptation is a strong urge and feeling to do evil. Do not give us the feeling to do evil, but deliver us from evil. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Principle 2. Am I making myself clear? Key of the kingdom. Luke 3:21. When all the people being baptized, Jesus, the maker of heaven and earth, the creator of heaven and earth, Elohim, almighty, all-powerful God, omnipotent God, went to be baptized by John. Jesus baptized too, and he was praying. I go participate in many baptism services, but all the preacher in Christianity do, they carry you on the water, and they carry another person with them to catch you, and they have you put your hand on your chest, and one hold you and immerse you in the water and pull you up. And they say, "Ask the authority as a minister of the gospel, I baptize you," but no prayer. But while baptism is being participated, you should be praying, because you are committing under that person's authority leadership. Jesus submit himself under John the Baptist leadership. John say, "You need to be baptized in me." Jesus had suffered it to be so now, for so is fulfilled all righteousness. The key, when he submits yourself, then heaven open up. When you pray, heaven is open up. Prayer open up the heaven, the kingdom. Heaven is a country, an invisible country. And prayer is the key that open up heaven. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom. Christians have a Bible, but they don't know what the keys are. They don't know how to operate the Bible. If I give you the key for my car, you must know what key start the car. If I give you the key for anything that I owned, you must know what key to operate, how to get in. If you say you're going to heaven, you must know how to enter in. The key to heaven is kingdom prayer. Every citizen have a key of heaven. There ain't no key to, but there's key off. The key of heaven unlock heaven open. Matthew 14:23, and when he had sent the multitude away, and he went into a mountain apart to pray. And when evening was come, he went there alone. There was no prayer meeting. He went there alone and he prayed. Notice, he went there alone by himself. Folks are so religious, Christianity, religious folk. They want to call a prayer meeting. They want to call folk along. And they want to get together. We're going to pray. We're going to tire. We're going to pray. The power and the keys of prayer to open up heaven is you got to go in the inner court and go alone. He went alone. And he prayed. And when evening come, he was there alone. Principle 3, prayer is intimacy relationship, like a husband and a wife. When they get together, marriage couple, just mom and dad, they shut the door, no noise. Everything is quiet. Just them alone. Intimacy. Relationship. When you get in the area of where God is, take off your shoe. Off your feet. For the place you are standing is holy ground. Intimacy. With God. Elohim. Luke 6:12. On those days, Jesus went out to the mountainside to pray and spend the night praying to God. He spent the whole 12 hours of prayer on his face before God. He spent the night, intimacy, like husband and wife spend the night together. Little talk to man, but more talk to God. He spent the night, intimacy, relationship. Folks say, I have a relationship with God. They go to the altar and pray, Lord, come in my heart, forgive me my sinner. Wash me in your blood, and I'm now your Christian and saved. That is not a relationship. A relationship is knowing the partner that you have a relationship with, knowing them, who they are, intimacy. Am I clear to you? Principle 4, kingdom law. Prayer is a law of the kingdom. Prayer is law of the kingdom. Why do you call me Lord and do not what I say? Why do you call me Lord, Lord, King, King, and you don't do what I say? He say a command that you have to obey, an authoritative command, prayer, Lord. He said, if my people, which are called by my name, should humble themselves and pray, that is a command, and turn from their wicked ways. Oh, they have some wicked, wicked religious folk. Wicked pastors, wicked deacon. If you shall turn from your evil ways, I will forgive your sin and heal your land. Prayer is a law. If you shall do what the king say, your land, your house, your family, your business, your job, will be safe, will be delivered, will be secure. The most important priority. 5, prayer is the most important priority in your life. Am I making myself clear? Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off a solemn place where he prayed. Folk in the religious church, they do more preaching, a lot of preaching. Everybody want to preach. Everybody want to say, I have a message. You need intimacy before you get a message. I'm making myself clear. Before Moses got the Ten Commandments, he had to go up 40 days and 40 nights. He spent with God alone. And when he turned with the law, which all nations use in the government, the Ten Commandments. Most important thing in your life is prayer. Your body is the most important power you have. When believers, kingdom citizens pray, the devil tremble. He shake. He taken with the nervousness and the shaking. Why? Because there's communication, there's power unto God. Am I clear? You need a body, you need to be legal on earth to pray. Dead man cannot pray. You need to be legal to pray. What is the most important thing in your life? It's your children, it's your house, it's your wife, it's your husband, it's your job, it's your money in the bank, it's your boat or your car or your vacation. What are important to you? What are your priorities? Jesus' most important priority is prayer. Prayer is the power of any ministry. The most important part in the ministry. Sunday morning, the whole church will park. Time to prayer. Just one or two old women, mama, praying, and they call them intercessor. But I get news for you. There's no ministry in the Bible of intercessors. There's no intercessors. There's no ministry. The Holy Spirit
the Holy Spirit intercede on our behalf. There is no ministry for intercessory. Am I making myself clear? Now, the seventh principle. Am I making myself clear? The seventh principle is understanding kingdom power, purpose in your life. Understanding the kingdom of God, purpose. What is God's purpose for you in your life? Understand it. To understand your purpose, it must come through prayer. Matthew 26, 36 to 46. Then Jesus went with his disciple into a solemn place. Am I making myself clear? Then Jesus went with his disciple into a solemn place called Gethsemane. And he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." Not sing, not preach. Sit here while I go to pray. And he took Peter and the two brothers, Zebedee, alone with him. He began sorrowful and troubled. He began sorrowful and troubled. Am I making myself clear? This is powerful. He began sorrowful and troubled. 38 verse. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death." The first time Jesus make mention anything but death, only once. He only preached the kingdom of God, but he made it to his disciple, not to a crowd of folk. This statement is not made to everybody, this family matter. He made it to his disciple. First time, he made it to his disciple. "My soul is sorrowful." Am I clear? Am I making myself clear to you? "My soul is sorrowful." 39. You mean he went further? He fell on his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, not may this cup be taken from me, yet not as I will, but as you will." The will of God, what the word Jesus came to do, the redemptive plan, the cross, Calvary, resurrection, blood, that was the redemptive work. It was in the cup. "Let this cup pass away, take it away from me." Am I making myself clear to you? When he came back, he again found them sleeping. Wake up, church. Wake up, Christian. Stop sleeping and pray. He found them sleeping. am I clear? Because their eyes were heavy. Because their eyes were heavy. So you can't, their eyes were heavy. They will not stay awake. So that you, he said that, stay awake and pray so that you won't enter in temptation. How can your word, temptation and sin and lust and evil, you got to stay awake that you may not enter in temptation? For the spirit is willing, but your flesh is weak. Again, the second time, he went away and prayed, my Father, if this cup pass or less, I drink it, your will be done. So the most important thing in Jesus' life was prayer. Pray that the will of God be made manifest in your life. Am I clear? After leaving them, he went away and prayed the third time, saying the same thing once more. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, are you still sleeping? Question, Pastor, are you still sleeping? Wake up! Wake up! Are you still sleeping watching ball game? Are you still sleeping playing golf? Are you still sleeping driving in your fancy luxury car? What are you doing? Wake up! Look! The time is near. The Son of Man is being betrayed in the hands of sinners. Get up! Let's go! See! My betrayer is nigh. My what? Betrayer is nigh. My betrayer is nigh. So understanding the will of God for your life. What is the will of God for your life? How can you know what God wants you to do? Why are you on planet Earth? Why are you here? You must pray. Prayer is the key of knowing God's will. Let him speak to you right now. Our Father, teach us to pray. Not your will, not my will, not my will, but your will be done in my life. I give you my body. I give you everything, Lord. Use me. Use me for your glory, O righteous Father. The world has not known you, but we have known you through Jesus Christ. I thank you, O Holy Father. Use us. Help us that we may understand these seven principles of the kingdom for prayer. Which art in heaven.
Speak to me.
Holy is your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. On earth. As in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our sins as we forgive our debt. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil one. Thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Shakes the heavens, the whisper on the wind breaks my inhibitions and settles me within. In mystery
Remember, we must pursue in pursuit of God, praying all night, seeking Him, praying all the time without fasting and prayer. This kind come by fasting and praying. This is Joseph, called Holy Prophet, Ambassador by the will of God. Till next session, may God bless you. Make His face shine upon you and give you peace.
Speak to me. I'm listening.